Take a bird, keep that in a golden cage, give timely nutritious food, mineral water. The bird has got a nice beautiful shelter and it is getting timely food, it has to do no work. But you think the bird is happy? Absolutely no. It wants to break free. Freedom is the ultimate thing. A convict who is in a prison, he gets 2 square meals a day. He has got a shelter on his head. You think he is happy? No, he too wants to break free. Freedom is the ultimate thing. We Indians were also confined. We were under the custody of some foreign nationals for many years. English people were ruling us. Then came Mahatma Gandhi, Subhash Chandra Bose, Bhagat Singh, and many known and unsung heroes. And because of their fight, because of their sacrifice, 1947, 15th August, India, when the whole world was asleep, we have awakened to freedom. And almost 70 years have gone by. Where are we now? We are all free. But today, we have taken this freedom so much granted that we stopped valuing it. Many countries who got independence after us, smaller countries, not rich in natural resources, even they don't even have human capital. Financially, they were very back, but they all become superpowers, rich countries. But we are still a developing country. We're still under the poverty line. Many governments came, many have gone, many leaders have come. They did promise a moon to all of us, and they've all gone by, and our life is like that only. Now, sometime I wonder, Gandhiji has sacrificed his life perfectly, okay? What is my role? What is my responsibility? How long will I sit on my past glory, singing songs about Gandhiji or Bhagat Singh or Subhash Chandra Bose? What am I supposed to do? People say, make money, okay? Donate, contribute, help. I'm not going to give any such lecture. On this Independence Day, can you take one oath that you don't have to beg anything from anyone for free? Can you stand on your own feet? Can you make your own living? Can you take care of your own family? No, beg the government or any social organization or NGO. Can you look after yourself? Because a country is nothing but sum total of all of us. And if I can become number one, if you can become number one, if our neighbor, if he too can become number one, if the another neighbor, if he too can become number one, I'm sure India will automatically become number one. Such is so easy solution. Forgetting about where to start, we want to change the whole world. I believe there was a person, and when he was on the deathbed and someone asked him, if you have to relive your life, is there something you want to change? He said, yeah, when I was young, I want to change the whole world. I tried, I couldn't. Then I thought, whole world is not possible. Let me change my country. I tried for many years, couldn't succeed. I said, whole country, not possible. Let me try with my state. I tried for many years, couldn't succeed. I said, whole state, not possible. Let me try with my city. I tried, could not succeed. I thought, at least my colony, I will try. For many years, I tried, could not succeed. Then I thought, at least let me try changing my family. For many years, I tried, I could not change. Then finally, I thought, at least if I can change my wife, I tried many years, could not succeed. Now I am on the deathbed. I am only thinking that if only I would have changed myself when I was young, looking at me, my wife, looking at her, my family, looking at her, my colony, looking at my colony, the whole city, looking at the city, whole state, looking at the state, whole country, looking at the country, whole world war changed. So I started everything reverse. So after reading so many self-help books, I can only understand that so many messiahs will come, so many leaders will come. But finally, I can tell you only one thing, that no one can change anyone's life because you are responsible to your own life. On this 15th August, India's Independence Day, if you truly love your nation, if you are a true Indian, and if you really value your freedom, can you just take one oath? Can you make one commitment that from today, I'm going to do every thinking, every act act of mine, every action of mine is going to take me to become number one. And I'm going to be the best citizen that I can be. I will be a role model, friend, neighbor, husband, father, mother, a citizen. If we can take that oath and if we can stick by that oath, and I'm sure India can become number one. So that day is not far. With 1.4 billion people, rich in human capital, seventh largest country in the whole world, 70 years plus after India's independence, we are still are saying developing country. Because my great grandfather used to tell my grandfather, India is a developing nation. My grandfather told my father, India is a developing nation. My father told me when I was a kid, India is a developing nation. I keep telling my son, India is a developing nation. I am only hoping that I live my life in such a way that before I die, I will tell my son, India is a developed nation. And from now, my son no longer has to tell India is a developing nation, but is a developed nation. So if you have little bit of patriotism in you, if you have little bit of nationalism in you, if you really would like to salute the Indian flag, if you are really proud of our India's rich heritage and culture, start from with yourself and see what is it that you can do to make India number one. Stop complaining and start working. Simple message, but very profound. Difficult to implement, but it is not impossible. We can do it. So, my fellow Indians, my fellow countrymen, arise, awake, stop not till we make India the number one nation. Thank you so much. Jai Hind. Jai Sima signing off.